spinning.
That is what worried.
Man, that thing is
tripping.
That car.
He's jumped.
You got that right.
Well, there's hope he's on a ride right
there. He's been incredibly fast. He got a huge runoff turn two, caught a pack of cars, made a quick move, and ended up in the fence.
Mike, it really wouldn't surprise me to see some kind of maybe adjustment on the speed here because the cars are really, really fast.
Yeah, that happened way too easy.
And he's climbed out. Jamie McMurray is out of the car. Thank goodness.
Crew members are all, standing around at 13. One of our faster cars. There's McMurray out of the car.
All right, let's see what happened here. As McMurray had a big run coming off, too.
See the 31 of Newman with a pretty good run. No, he maybe cut a tire.
Something happened to that car. It just went around all by itself on the straightaway.
And see, what really set that car over was when Newman hit him on the left side, it lifted the right side up and caught air.
Yeah.
And look at that car start come rolling. Apart against the fence.
It just disintegrates.
I mean, everything did its job of what it's designed to do. The fence kept the car on the racetrack. Car stayed intact.
Watch this car now. It's just gonna turn all by itself right there.
Oh, left the left rear. Left rear tire.
Yeah. Right over the top of Newman's car.
The time. A terrible one.
He's struggling.
Searching his first. Oval, first oval track win. He won it in Finneon 96 races ago on the road course.
And who
a second. And the 99 has turned over Brad Keselowski.
And we have a caution.
I don't know if I'm okay.
Keselowski was on track for a sixth place finish.
Boy,
we're told there was contact between Edwards and Keselowski.
And have we seen that somewhere once before?
Talladega last year, and early in this race at lap 41.
A little crossover move here by Carl. Clean here, clean here. Just slight contact.
Oh,
look at that thing go.
That looks so much like Edwards' turnover at Talladega off the bumper of Keselowski.
It really did, and I'm so wondering and hoping that when they put the spoiler back on these cars, they'll quit turning over like this.
Keselowski's put the window net down.
The roof flaps deployed, but it did not set that car back down. I'm like you, Darrell. I'm going to be so glad to see that rear spoiler back on these cars.
I think there's got to be something to that.
That car took a hard hit in the left A-pillar, the windshield post, right in front.
Projected off the other cars right up into the fence.
He went from the bottom of the racetrack over two rows of cars and into that catch fence.
Here we go. You can see him on the bottom. Rex starts in front. He runs in the back of the 24. Gets up on the 11. Now he's on top of the 50.5. Now it's just along for the ride. Watch the car stop. Watch the car stop. It gets in those poles, and it goes from, I don't know, what, 180, 190 miles an hour, I'm just guessing, to a complete stop. That is unbelievable.
Session for all three series on the backstretch. Eric Almirola from Joe Gibbs Racing makes some contact coming down the track and ends up on his roof. Fortunately, only the car was damaged. It was a very scary-looking tumble, mostly because he was upside down for quite a while, but the safety crews at the track got the car back on its wheels and got Almirola out, but a tough way to get accustomed to.
It's going to be a drag race. I'm after the start finish line. No
Kevin did. Oh, there
he goes. Gun to the wall. There's with the one of McCurry. Three, four cars around. One on its roof. One car hard into the wall.
That was a...
And it ends in flames and sparks.
Our front row sitter up here, he's got a torn up race car.
Mark
78
Schick.
Car. Jimmy Johnson. He looks okay. Front end of his car on fire. McMurray crawls across the start-finish line to earn a spot in the 500. The field is frozen as of the caution flag. And Jamie McMurray's car, all torn up. 59 and a half great laps, and then this.
I just didn't have a good feeling when Jimmy Johnson and Jeff Gordon got side by side. I felt like that was not a good move for either one of them, and of course, we had trouble.
Michael Waltrip's car into the pit wall. And Michael moving around in the car.
What did he do? He implemented a specialized team completely dedicated to restrictor plate racing. Less than a dozen people. Oh, and we've got trouble on the track, and it's Kyle Busch upside down.
Big time crash. Kyle Busch goes upside down and rolls down across on his roof here on lap 26. Cars comes back over now, side over side, barrel rolls. And comes to rest on its wheels. A horrific crash here at Talladega on lap 26 involving Kyle Busch. And thankfully, the window net is down there. The safety crew's on the scene immediately, and Kyle Busch is climbing out of that car. Wow. Listen to this crowd.
Well, that's a true testament to the safety of these race cars. See him just jump out of that car like that. That was what looked like a very violent wreck, but, man, he just jumped right out of there. It's a real testament to the safety features that these cars have.
Yeah. Outside lane, hanging tough here on the restart.
Oh, here we go.
Trouble. That's Casey Kane to go sideways. Joey Logano nowhere to go.
Half the field is dies.
The big one at Daytona has happened at lap 97.
That is the huge one at Daytona.
Justin Allgaier.
Oh, the team gets on its roof.
Kyle Busch rolls upside down.
Wow.
See the 26 car of Cole Whitt, the 38 of David Gilliland.
Just having a good old time over here. Just hanging around. Okay, just stay buckled up. Let him get your foot over here.
That's Kyle Busch.
You have a really good chance to see here how two tires do work.
Casey Kane gets a terrible start there.
And Kurt Busch trying to move to the inside and take that spot away and take the lead away from
pretty heavy crash here on lap 32. See Robbie Gordon, Martin Truex, Reed Sorensen involved in this. Looked up, saw the 20 car on the apron getting into the corner.
But they did send it down. Look at that straight away. A big hit, and Jimmy Johnson goes
straight down. Busher. Oh, man.
Chris Busher on his lid and lands back on his wheels. Caution.
Oh, man. We saw four right off the corner over there. I was afraid of it.
Okay.
Great camera work capturing this. Ooh, look at rookie Chris Busher's wild ride down the backstretch.
It's been a while since we've seen one do this. Well, now he's out front. He's pretty happy with his race car. He said, back in the pack, it was a bit edgy, but as soon as he could get some clean air on that car, he said, I think we're going to have a fast race car. His spotter, Eddie DeHaan, just told him, it's time to be greedy.
Oh, there he goes. Oh, there we go. Here we go.
Oh, upside down. Upside.
Well, AJ, that was a humdinger.
Yes, it was, and that's, there he is, upside down, and I hope he's all right. I see him moving around in there. I don't think there's any issue with him.
Yeah, you just can't push on the left side of that rear bumper.
Well, you just can't keep pushing. He got into the 24 and just kept on pushing. But, Mike, I'm telling you, I started my first race in 1972. This was what I'm worried about.